The chair recognizes the Representative Owens for 5 minutes.
Unmute.
Can you,
or just need unmute.
Can you unmute?
Sorry, okay. According to the USA Today, last year, 2020, the United States tallied more than 20,000 murders, the highest total since 1995, and 4,000 more than 2019. Preliminary FBI data for 2020 points to a 25% surge in murders, the highest single year increase since the agency began publishing uniform data in 1960. For the record, hate is hate, hate is evil, regardless of the color. To the victims of hate and their families, it makes no difference the color of the perpetrator. The result is the same, death. Looking at the numbers, I'm gonna guess that white on black crimes are up, black on white crimes are up, black on Asian crimes are up, attacks against Hispanics and Jewish community are up. And for sure, black on black crime is up. 90% of the black crimes perpetrated on black Americans are done by other blacks. This evil of hate has become so prevalent that too many Americans, both black and white, simply shrug their shoulders, think it's normal, and turn the page. I keep hearing from my friends across the aisle about white supremacy. But based on the unconscionable high death tally of black Americans in our own communities, it's evident that evil white supremacists is not our greatest threat. It is evil black perpetrators, predators living among us. I ask my fellow lawmakers not to continue to think this plague of evil is normal, shrug our shoulders, and turn the page. It's time for us to work together to end the policies that's keeping too many poor black Americans living mostly in urban cities, living in fear, illiteracy, joblessness, hopelessness, and anger. With that, I want to turn the remainder of my time over to Mr. Jordan.